So it's the hottest accessory this season. It's Sandbox Magazine, the homegrown magazine that's creating a lot of buzz in this River City.
Jeffrey and Braden from Sandbox. This is an impressive thing that you guys have put together. Tell everybody what's going on.
We just started this new magazine. It's fashion, lifestyle, culture, and we think it's like nothing else that Winnipeg has right now.
The scene here actually is really huge, really exciting, and really like emerging right now in terms of even a national fashion scene, and it's starting right here in Winnipeg, so that's the exciting part.
I love fashion, and I love culture and the arts, and I just think Winnipeg's such a great place. There's so much talent.
And I think Winnipeg's often dismissed as not fashionable, and there's nothing here to do, and people always move out of the city to find different venues and opportunities. But what we're focusing on is that we have that stuff here, and we're celebrating that.
People in Winnipeg are humble and they're modest, but they're damn talented.
This like collective we've created, this community of people who are talented, passionate, creative, like invested in the Winnipeg fashion and culture scene.
So striking when I saw it, and I just was blown away that this was, I found myself saying something that I hate hearing from other people. I mean, this is from Winnipeg?
The best support we get, though, is just those random little emails or messages that say, this is exactly what people needed, or we just love Sandbox so much, thank you for doing this for us. That's what keeps us going.
Yeah, just an overwhelming sense of support, and definitely this is something that other people are seeing. We knew, but other people are seeing that this is what Winnipeg needed.
To us, it represents having fun, being creative, like having a space to play and be yourself.
There's a lot of people doing a lot of interesting things in the city, and so it's nice to be able to celebrate that. I mean, I think it's really important.
We originally planned the magazine to be for a younger audience, but it's just been so popular with all ages, including, you know, people in their late 30s, 40s, and 50s.
And the hardest part, the funding, the money, the business, is the worst and most difficult part for us and the way we work. Like,
right now my credit card's maxed out.
Yeah, God.
The first print is on my credit card, so that's basically how we pay for it.
It takes a lot of time to make a magazine, and you have a constant deadline over your head, and it's something that you need to devote your full time, 40-hour a week energy to, and we just can't right now.
It's really sad. Obviously, I'm kind of a little bit heartbroken about it, but I think it's important that we're ending well. Things are really good.
You know, I've all shed our tears about it, but I think we all know that it's time.